and I am joined by a very, very, very special guest. I had to say the three verys because once I reveal who it is, you're going to be like, yeah, now you're right. Man like Kit from Top Boy, a.k.a. Kadeem Ramsay.
In the building, I mean.
So I said this to you off air, and I'm going to say it again with Chess because you need to hear this. Your performance in season two...
Well, you took it
out the bag.
Oh, thank you, man. I'm trying.
The bag, you secured the bag, you wrapped up the bag, and you threw it back out. You literally, I feel like this was just a performance. I've seen you in obviously the first season. I've also seen you in Sex Education.
Yeah.
And you are obviously talented as an actor, but it's just, I don't know. I can't describe it. I just know. I was just watching your scenes in this series, and I mean, I had to message you anyway, jaw was just on the floor with certain of your scenes. How do you feel like season two has reflected your performance as an actor?
You know what? I feel like I'm actually just happy that I had a bit more to do in season two, in fact. You know what I'm saying? I'm happy that, you know, they went into my character a bit more in depth. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You know,
a lot in depth. It's like we got to see so many different sides of Kit this season. It was good.
Yeah, it was just fun to be able to, you know, play that sort of character. Like, I don't know, I liked it. I just really liked it still.
Yeah. When you first got the script,
What, from the first season or this?
From season two.
Okay, yeah.
What was your reaction like specifically to your scene where you killed Dexter?
You know, it's crazy. I didn't know that I was gonna do that yet.
Really?
Yeah, because at the time they were still obviously like writing drafts for the other episodes.
Mm-hmm.
So like they probably sent out like episode 1 and 2.
Mm-hmm.
And they're still editing the rest. So because they're still editing the rest, they're not gonna send it out. So I didn't know what that was gonna happen yet.
Really?
But when I did find out, I was like, yeah, okay, yeah, they made me redeem myself from the last season, from when I ran into the yard with a shotty. Like, yeah.
And it was like, now we're going to see the full, going to see the level of the hangar
trust me.
You can really do. That scene itself was incredible. Like the twist in it, the writing of it, but the way you performed in it. I want to know, how did you go about preparing yourself for filming this scene?
More time, I swear to you. I just, as I said in another interview, brother, I just drink juice and eat a little food. I don't even think about it too tough because I try not to. Like that's one of the main things I try to always remember when it comes to like just being on screen.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you're meant to like live in that moment, embody that character. It's like you don't want to think about how you're gonna do something because then it's gonna be fake. You get it? So it's just about actually being in that moment, and so that's why I never think about it. I just go on the camera, boom, action, all right, cool.
Really, you know
what
I'm saying? Just
like switch, boom.
That is mad. Even to the point where it was like the way the panic in your face when like Deshane was coming and you were like trying to cover up all the evidence. Spoiler alert, by the way, if you have not watched Top Boy, switch off this interview. But like the panic in your face, the way you did it. So you said that you had to actually do a bit of training.
Yeah, that scene there was we did rehearsal for that scene still because obviously we was using like a crowbar.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to be careful of how far I'm swinging it, how close I'm getting to a man's head and that. So but even rehearsal, the crowbar was plastic, but the real one, the real scene, it was a real crowbar. But I wasn't really hitting, it looked like I'm hitting him, but they put like some sort of cushion there or something, so.
Oh, is it?
Basically like,
Because you was caving man's head in, I was like, oh, look at the gory.
But the other bits where you see the thing hit his head, like that was obviously a fake built head that you get.
Yeah. Oh my god, it was one of the best scenes of the whole series.
Mental, innit? Mental.
Like when you wrapped that, how was it between you and I don't know the actor's name?
No, it was calm still. Even from the rehearsal.
Like, man, you bust my head, fam.
Literally, even from the rehearsal, it was funny still. It was funny doing the rehearsals, man.
Yeah.
Very funny, yeah.
So with this season, you're like we mentioned before, your whole storyline kind of came out a bit. It advanced, I would say. Now, looking back at it, how do you feel like it has helped you elevate as an actor generally? So, like, if we were to look forward now, how do you feel like your performance in season two is going to help you with new jobs?
Honestly, that's a good question because I've never thought about it like that, to be honest. I like to look at it like, you know what, I'm willing to take on challenges.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not kind of expecting to take on another character that's kind of similar to Kit,
mm-hmm.
if that makes sense. So it's like, I am actually open to challenges to see my range, if that makes sense.
Yeah, like, no, it does.
I want to be challenged.
I feel like we got a little bit of that, but we're going to keep it right there and we're going to go into some new tunes. Stay right there. And welcome back. You are listening to me, Nye, live on Represent 107.3 FM. If you're just joining me, I am joined by Top Boy's very own Kadeem Ramsay.
There you are.
So, Kadeem, I have to ask. Mm-hmm. I feel like the hype for Top Boy season one was massive, but mm-hmm. I feel like this season's hype was major. And even the aftermath, it's been trending in multiple countries, mm-hmm. not just the UK. You were number one on Netflix for like weeks, yeah. but also in France, in America. So how was filming for season one different to filming for season two?
You know what? Everything I feel like, you see season one, yeah? Like, the way how everyone's so close already, like, I love it. Everyone's actually like family on set already, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? But season two, there wasn't certain people that was there from season one. So it's like, in that side of things, it kind of felt a little different. But other than that, what feels different is the attention going out. Like, I just know it's different from this one, innit?
Can you go Tesco?
No.
Can you go Tesco now, innit?
No, it's mad still. Like, the other day I went Box Park.
Yeah.
Went with two of my other friends and that were there. And as soon as you walked in, I'm straight bombarded. Like, we had to leave out of there still.
Oh, like, you had to leave?
Because I wasn't with, like,
security people, or anything, security, yeah.
nothing like that. Like, I'm just there with, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
And it's got too much. So I'm just there to chill and just enjoy the music and have a juice, but everyone's just coming with their phones like this, snapping. And
yeah, man. It must be a crazy feeling.
Nah, it's mad.
Because I'm sure you probably used to go Box Park, Shoreditch, and all those places normally.
It's calm. Like, yeah. I don't get that when I used to go there before, but now it's like, bro, what are you saying? I can't even go Box Park no more. Like, come on.
You're a whole celebrity now, Kadeem.
Don't feel like that.
Doesn't feel like
No, man, I'm a very humble you. I know where I come from still, so nothing like that can even change my perception of how I look at stuff. So.
Really? I love hearing that. That's like, really nice to hear.
Literally, the other day, I was in an event, that man's eating caviar, but trust me, I prefer mackerel.
Like, he said the mackerel,
listen,
yeah?
I say that in the tune that you're going to, like, trust me, I say it still, like, it's real talk.
Really? So all the glitz and glamour, the red carpets, none of that has...
It's pretty, but...
That's, you know what, that's really interesting and, like, as a fan to hear, because you'd think now, like, you're a celebrity, you just, you know, you're a celebrity.
Listen, when you realise that everyone just sees you and everyone just wants to come up to you and take a picture, like, you realise that your privacy is all you have, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's the only thing you have. So it's like, to me, it's like, it's the only thing I'm holding on to, if that makes sense.
How have you been able to kind of protect your privacy right now?
I mean, I'll show what I want people to see, innit?
Yeah, and you have your trusty Bally as well.
You know what I'm saying? I just got to move correctly.
Yeah, it's just crazy. But it's just a reflection of how good you are and, you know, how blessed you are and how well you've done in Top Boy. So I wanted to ask about the fans... I'm watching Top Boy, because Kano tweeted a response to a fan who had said they'd finish Top Boy in a day.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he said something along the lines of, we film for the amount of time it takes us to film for you to finish it all like that. Like, that's mad. But what's your take on it? Because, like, you guys do work so hard and you film for so long, and some people will literally finished it. They finished it in a day.
No, it is mental. I don't, you know, how quick did they say?
They said they finished it in a day.
In a day?
Yeah. Some people have been watching it in a day.
It's possible still. Yeah, it's possible still.
But does it make you feel a bit like, do you feel like Netflix and just like people, like Netflix should release it weekly and not like all at once, that people can?
That's exactly what I was even saying that to them as well. Like, I would even prefer if, like, even though they're not going to take me in, but I was even saying, no, man, it should be a weekly thing. Like, the way how this season was mad, like, mm-hmm. I feel like everyone would have just been invested at the same time, episode by episode, do you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But like, for the fact that it just came out from, we already know social media, people can't hold their tongues.
Mm-hmm. There were loads of spoilers.
Hella spoilers everywhere. Mm-hmm. So yeah, man, I was saying it was a weekly thing, man.
Do you feel like it kind of not dimmed the light a bit, but was just a little, I don't want to say disappointed, but just a little bit like, oh, like, where people were finishing it so quickly and not like kind of like lengthening out watching the episodes?
I mean, yeah, there's a pro, the pros and the cons, you know what I'm saying? Mm. Like, it's shitting on people that ain't seen it, but at the same time, it's good publicity for the show at the same time, because for the fact that people are talking about it, and this one's like, oh, why did you do that, man? Nah, they gotta go and watch it now because it's been spoiled for them, so they gotta watch it now. Mm. Do you know what I'm saying? And it's like, it's just a knock-on effect.
Mm. No, that's true. So I want to talk about, because obviously the storyline and the way it ended was crazy. No one expected
it.
How did you feel when you found out what was going to happen?
Honestly,
to your character?
Honestly, I was pissed.
Yeah.
Honestly, I was, because like, I was actually laying in my hospital bed when they told me.
Yeah.
That's another thing as well. Like, it's like, bro, what do you mean you're killing man's character? For what? Mm. How? Why? Mm. Do you know what I'm saying? And
so how did that even go about? Like, they just called you and was like,
you know what's mad? I got a message from the producer. Obviously, he said he wanted to speak to me, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Just to check up on me. I think he was gonna call me the next day, but instead I got a call from my agent.
Mm-hmm.
And it was my agent that told me. So I think he told my agent, and my agent told me.
Oh, okay.
But obviously, it's the way she told me was like, oh, they're going to be killing your character. I was thinking, what? I literally sat up in my bed. What do you mean, what?
Yeah.
For what? Why?
Yeah.
But she, like, she just kind of showed me, like, you ain't got to be, like, angry. Do you know what I'm saying? At the same time, it was a good role to play. Mm-hmm. Your character's going out on a high. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, so
I feel like your death was dignified. We didn't even see it, really.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
we didn't see you, you know, with me, honestly, tongue hanging out of your mouth or nothing.
It didn't make sense for me, though. Honestly, it didn't make sense for me. Like, I honestly feel like a decision was made, and a split decision was made, like a quick one.
Yeah.
For political reasons, I don't know, but because I just don't feel it makes sense anyway, but
No, that's fair enough. Welcome back. And if you are just joining me, I am joined by Top Boy's very own Kadeem Ramsay. So I need to get your opinion on this, because there's been a bit of I can't say the word.
Conspiracy
theories regarding the ending of Top Boy. And if you are tuning in, we are doing spoilers, so please do tune out if you haven't watched Top Boy. And a lot of people don't think Jamie is dead, because fans have been watching that every time he answers the door, he always looks through the spy hole. And at the end scene where Sully came, he didn't look through the spy hole, so people think that it might be a dream. This is the theory, that Jamie's not dead and this is all a dream. What's your take on it?
I know, this is the thing, like, people are mad, like like, bruv, you saw what you saw in it. You saw a man got two
bullets in his head,
in his chest, and one where he used to think, you know what I'm saying? So you told me if it was a dream in it.
And now you heard it. You heard it from Jamie's best friend himself. No,
it is. The ending is a bit mad, though.
Did you feel about the ending? Did you watch it back this season?
You know what? Where I first watched it back was when I went to go do the ADR session for it.
Okay.
You know what ADR is?
No, I don't. ADR. Look at me saying okay, like I know.
No, ADR is basically like, you know, after you finish filming it, if they haven't got sound that they wanted properly, mm-hmm. you'll go to the recording studio and you'll record the sound properly, or they want to add in certain sounds here or something. So basically recording studio to add in sounds, you know what I'm saying? So it was literally that, when I had that session, that's when I saw it and I was thinking, bro, my boy literally just done my dance, bro. Like,
it was crazy.
It looked mad, but at the same time, I was still thinking, nah, this don't make no sense, though, man. It don't make no sense. And I honestly feel like, yeah.
It was crazy, because I'm not going to lie. I was thinking, Jamie ain't gonna kill Kit.
Exactly.
He ain't going to kill Kit. They're going to, you know, rise together and kill or go against Deshane and Sully.
To be honest, like, the reason why I say it don't make sense is, like, man's got to remember, yeah, how close me and him are, yeah. Mm. Our beef that we have with Summer House. Like, you've got to remember how that is as well.
You lot tried to kill each other in series one, yeah.
And now you're telling me all of a sudden, because he's out working for someone from Summer House now, he's suddenly switched on me like that. Like, without hesitation. Do you know what I'm saying? That's the only reason why it don't make sense to me. Do you get it?
Yeah, there's a lot of question marks. I'm not going to lie, throughout the whole season, I've always liked your character. But with the whole thing with Ats, I'm not going to lie, I was looking at you sideways. Because we...
Why? Why was you looking at me sideways? Let me tell you something right now. Let me tell you something. You see, from the last season, yeah.
Yeah.
When I ran into the house with a shot, what was you thinking? You was thinking, blah, innit? You was thinking, yeah.
Yeah.
And now, what? Oh my God, they killed a little boy.
Yeah, because he's a little boy.
Well, you was rooting for me a while ago, so what happened?
Innit, we are not loyal. No, but I just felt, maybe, I don't know, I had a change of heart. Like, he just made a mistake. He's just trying to get some money.
I know. And this is the thing. I didn't actually mean for that to actually happen, though. Like, you know what I'm saying? But that's the thing, though. In life, that actually happens. Mm. You know, people actually do that. They will probably tell someone, yeah, this happened. I beg you, go and sort that out for me. But don't do nothing mad, though. But,
and then Matt, you know what I'm saying? Will just, yeah.
It happens. Mm. Literally, life, real life.
And just on that storyline aspect as well, because you mentioned obviously about how close your character and Jamie's character is. Mm-hmm. I want to talk about your relationship outside of Top Boy, because I saw Michael post some like snaps and stuff, and it's just you and him, and you really do have a brotherhood there, and it's really nice to see. How do you guys support each other on the days where, you know how it gets, we're not all feeling 100, and maybe you're having doubts about how you've done something, and people are chatting rubbish online
literally
about you.
More time we're baked off on FaceTime anyway. Like, literally, more time we're just baked off chatting on FaceTime.
Not so baked off.
Like, yeah, just laying down, chilling, chatting on FaceTime, or like, you know what I'm saying, if it's not talking about, oh, bro, what are you trying to do? Like, yeah, you got to try pattern this, or sort out this, or like, we're always trying to encourage each other. You know what I'm saying?
I love that. Yeah. Would you want to work with Michael again?
Of course.
Are you going to work with Michael again?
It was even mad, and it was even a blessing to even like work with him on 3 projects, like back to back. Like, I went from Top Boy, where I was Kit and Jamie, mm-hmm. to Blue Story, Hakeem mm-hmm. and Marco,
mm-hmm.
and then obviously Small Axe, Samson Franklin.
Yeah, you guys just really bounce off each other really well. Literally, that's why it's like, it's so nice to see your brotherhood. Okay, cool. So I'm gonna play a little game with you,
mm-hmm.
because I am.
You even tell me about no game.
Yeah, no. You know, I like the element surprise. So, you know, if you didn't know, I'm from Bristol.
Okay.
And
Bristolian.
In exactly.
Is that what you call it?
Yeah, we're Bristolians.
Jeez, I guessed it as well.
Yeah, you did. Well done. And in Bristol, we have our own, you know, accents. So this game is called How Well Is Your Twang? Okay. And what you need to do is I'm going to give you a couple of phrases that we use in Bristol. Okay. And you have to try and say it in your best attempt at doing a Bristolian accent. Look at your face.
Yeah, because I'm even trying to deep. Like, have I even heard a Bristol?
It's all right, because I'm going to show you what a Bristolian person sounds like. Okay. So don't worry. Okay.
I don't even think of it. What?
So this is what this is. So obviously, my accent isn't very strong.
You sound like we could be from the same block. What do you
mean? I know. Everyone says that. Well, no. Everyone doesn't say I'm from London, but they don't think I'm from Bristol because I don't sound like this.
How are you guys? All right?
Yeah, good.
Yeah. It's lovely to see you. But
where's Reggie?
I think he'll be coming on a bit later.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he loves a bit of attention. Oh, he's so good.
He's so gorgeous.
I am so blessed. Oh. And I don't know why, because his dad's not a looker, and I don't.
So that is what a traditional Bristolian accent sounds like, okay? So now I'm going to read you first. So one of our biggest phrases that we have is we say, All right, my lover, okay? Which is basically what it means is, like, you're right, love? Yeah. That sort of thing, right? So, using the best Bristolian twang that you have, my love, try and say to me...
You're right, my love. Hold on. Clear my throat. So it's what, you're right, my lover?
So it's all right, my lover?
All right, my lover. All right, my lover.
That was actually really good. Okay, that was really good. All right, let's try another one. So another phrase that we say is, it's a bit harsh, isn't it? But how we say it in Bristol is we go, it's a bit harsh, isn't it?
Say that one more time, bro.
So if you wanted to say, it's a bit harsh, isn't it?
It's a bit harsh.
We go, it's a bit harsh, isn't it?
It's a bit harsh, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, it sounds like exhibit arch, innit? Like, you know, exhibit arch, innit?
Exhibit
like,
arch. Okay, you're doing really well, by the way. Okay, we're going to do one last final one. Now, this is one that we always say, like, if you go Bristol, you'll hear it. And it basically means, like, oh, this is well nice, like, well lovely. We go, oh, that's girt lush. The confusion on your face right now.
Skirt. What?
So we say that's skirt lash.
That's skirt lash.
Girt lash.
Girt lash or skirt lash?
Girt lash.
That's girt lash.
That's girt lash.
That's girt lash.
Sounding a little bit Australian.
That's girt lash.
Oh my God. Apart from that last one sounding a bit Australian, you actually did really well. You're the first person to do this game, and I'm going to rate your Bristolian. I'm rating your twang a 7, so well done to you.
Cool.
I'm
going to work on it a bit more then.
That was actually really good. Okay, we will be back with some more from Kadeem Ramsay. Stay there. And welcome back. You are listening to me, Nye, and I am joined by Top Boy's very own Kadeem Ramsay. Mister, I'm going to call you Mr. Twangin right now because you actually did really good in that game.
I was really trying. I don't know if you could tell, I was really trying.
Yeah, you really was. And like, can you do any other accents?
I don't want to embarrass myself.
I'm sure you won't be able to do that. So obviously, like, Top Boy's out now. You know, unfortunately, your character has gone. So how was it parting ways with everyone? And what was your last day of shooting like?
I ain't even going to say parting ways. Like, look, man still chats to everyone, you know what I'm saying? Everyone's still family, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
That is still fam. But I know what you mean, though. No, it's just literally, I'm looking at this, yeah, moving on to bigger and better. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I've actually going to start doing some stuff on my own as well. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I want to give other people some opportunities as well. I think it's that time now. Also other stuff that I'm working on as well, like music.
Yes, you know, which we will, because tell me about, you got my Jamaican twang coming out now. Talk about twang. So you've dropped a single called Cautious.
Yeah.
Absolute banger. Mm-hmm. Now, did you do music? Were you doing music prior to acting, or is this a new venture?
Before acting, yeah.
Okay.
I've always had a passion for music. I would say I had a passion for music probably since like primary school, like year 4, year 5 times. Like, okay. I would always mess about with my friends, like just freestyling, and you know what I'm saying? And then it got to like, I'll say year 9, year 10, I started like recording songs in secondary school and putting them on Facebook. Mm. Like, even up to this day, it's there.
But where can I find them?
That's the thing, you ain't finding it.
Why?
You ain't finding it.
Why? I want to say, okay, well. Tell us a bit about Cautious, because you teamed up with Smiler.
Yeah. Shouts out my guy, Smiler. Had to get him on the feature still. Literally, it was so mad how it even happened as well, because obviously, the studio that I was even at, it was in his area. Mm-hmm. Obviously, he's my brethren anyway. So I just shouted him, seen what he was on, told him I'm at the studio. He pulled up. He heard the rhythm I was working on. Mm-hmm. He just started dropping bars, and I was just thinking, yeah. I was like, no, lay that. You know what I'm saying? Lay it. That's cold. So,
play it right
and
back.
And then this is what we made, you know what I'm saying? Literally.
And now that you've obviously got this out, what's the response been like from your fans? Because obviously we know you got fans now, honey.
I know.
Can't go Tesco now, honey.
It's crazy because I like to surprise people. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I like the element of surprise. Like, people didn't know that I do music as well, or I could rap or nothing like that. So it's a nice feeling to just catch people off guard like that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I love that. So what's next? Obviously, you said you're going to be focusing a bit more on yourself, but do you have anything that you can tell us that's coming up?
Yeah, you're right. We're focusing on ourselves right now.
Doing me. And, wait, before I ask what's next, I do have to, because we spoke about something really important off air, and you were actually unwell whilst you were filming Top Boy, and I just want to address that because that is amazing. But how... Just tell the listeners, tell everyone who's tuned in right now, like, how it was for you at that time without, obviously, you know, going into too much.
Yeah, no, this was literally during, like, filming Top Boy. This happened probably, like, the start of January 2021. Mm-hmm. I was literally in hospital for, like, 3 weeks, going four. And, they found an abscess in my liver, so I had to get it drained out and stuff like that. But I was, like, I was wounded, like, I was done out here. Like, could have lost my life still. Thank God I'm still here.
Amen.
Like, for real.
You had to film.
Yeah, and this is the thing, like, when I came out, I got the bubble gum in my mouth. When I came out, like, instead of actually, like, taking the time to recover, like, me, I can't lie, I missed being on set. Like, I really missed it. So even though these lot wanted me to kind of, like, they wanted me on set, but at the same time, they want me to chill and get better. So it's like, Kadeem, if you need the time to actually heal, like, take it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm saying, nah, man, the show's got to go on. So still going on set, still filming with the tube in me. Like, that scene where we did the shootout. Mm-hmm. You know when we had to go and get Sully from the room? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That was the day. Like, and I had the bag tucked into my trousers.
Oh, wow.
With the tube still inside of me.
Oh, wow. All that running up and down.
Literally. So it's like, trying to do that as, and finishing at 4 a.m. as well that day. Like, yeah. It was a killer still. It was a killer.
That's mad. You're just so strong. I wanted to just suggest that because I just think it. You said before, you said the show must go on, and that is literally the show must go on. Literally. So, big things for you. Honestly, big things for you. And thank you so much for joining me. It's always a pleasure having you on the show.
I had to. It's been a while as well since we.
It's literally series one. Literally, series one, you came, and now you're here for series two. And like, you know, I always appreciate you. You know, I'm always supporting you.
Come on. Gang,
so. If you want to catch Kadeem's latest single, you can find it where?
Everywhere still. You can catch it on YouTube, Spotify, Tidal, SoundCloud. Tidal. Yeah, man. You can find that everywhere.